And now it's time for On the Money with your host, Dan White. Dan has been in the financial services industry for over 25 years, and he's been a featured expert in Forbes, Yahoo, the Philadelphia Business Journal, Dow Jones Market Watch, and has appeared nationally on Fox Business News. Dan is a member of some of the most prestigious financial organizations, including the Society of Financial Service Professionals and the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. In addition, he's a chartered life underwriter and a chartered financial consultant. Credentials you can trust. Broadcasting from the heart of Wilmington, Delaware, here's your host of On the Money, Dan White.
When I think about what I do, I don't just think of it as a numbers game. These are people's lives. And behind every life is a story. And so my job is to help my retirees tell a better story about their life. What will your story say when it's all said and done? I hope it is a story of sweet success. You know, one of the best storytellers on the radio was a guy by the name of Paul Harvey. Remember the weekday radio show by Paul Harvey, The Rest of the Story? Harvey would describe something the audience would know only in part or not at all, and he would then explain the whole thing, what he called the rest of the story. And I am no Paul Harvey, but I would like to take Paul Harvey's approach this morning. There is another side of retirement planning also. We know or even see situations where the individual or couple's retirement looks challenging and diminished. Some situations, the retirement situation even looks impossible. I was reading a retirement-related story when I saw an expert quoted in the press release for a major research report on retirement planning. And I quote, "America has never seen so many people reaching retirement age over a short period, and well over half of them will find it challenging to meet their needs through their retirements." This was said by Dr. Robert Shapiro, former Undersecretary of Commerce for Economic Affairs. Shapiro is the leader of the research group that published the Peak Boomers Impact Study this past April. He has a PhD in economics from Harvard. And this study comes from the Alliance for Lifetime Income, an important and credible nonprofit consumer education organization based in Washington, D.C. And I can summarize this major study in one sentence. A majority of peak boomers are not financially prepared for retirement. Well, what is the rest of the story? Welcome to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. And this morning, we're going to talk about the retirement challenges of peak 65 boomer women. Before we get into the program, though, I do have a couple announcements. We have a birthday in our office this week. I want to wish a happy birthday to our favorite operations and communications manager, Lauren Forlin. Lauren celebrates a birthday this week, so we want to wish her a very happy birthday. We have a giveaway today. We have a giveaway. It's called the 2024 Secure Act Brochure. Last week, we gave you final regulations on the Secure Act and the Secure Act 2.0. So this brochure kind of summarizes that. So if you'd like to get a copy of the 2024 Secure Act brochure, pick up the phone and give us a call. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820 in Pennsylvania. It's a local call, 610-358-8942. 610-358-8942. We have three upcoming events this week. On Tuesday, August the 20th at 5:30 p.m., Dan Simon will be out at 9 Prime in Westchester, PA, doing our very popular Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. Also on Tuesday the 20th at 6 p.m., I'll be down in the Lewis, Delaware area. I'll be at the Lewis Public Library in Lewis, Delaware, doing a Council of Financial Educators workshop. This one is Social Security. Know your options. Deciding when and how to claim your Social Security benefits. Two of the most important decisions you'll need to make can be confusing and even overwhelming. And this program will talk through all the intricacies of claiming Social Security. Make sure you're not leaving money on the table. And then on Wednesday, the 21st at 6 p.m., we have another Council of Financial Educators program at Rachel Cole Library on Smithbridge Road in Glen Mills, Taxes in Retirement. Again, taxes are a big element in retirement. You want to try to craft a tax-efficient retirement plan. So if you're not doing anything on Wednesday, the 21st at 6 p.m., you want to come out to Rachel Cole Library to find out how we can help you do just that. All right, so what is the rest of the story, as Paul Harvey would say? I want to discuss specifically the consequences and the dangers of what this means for unmarried women who are peak boomers. Peak boomers are the youngest of the baby boomer birth cohort. Baby boomers, as you know, were born in the years 1946 through 1964. Those boomers born near the end of this period during the last 5 years include the greatest number of boomers turning age 65. I mean, it's crazy, the number of people turning age 65. More than 4.1 million Americans will turn 65 each year through 2027, which amounts to more than 11,200 Americans retiring every day. This year is the record for Americans turning age 65. Next year will break the 2024 record before tapering off for the last few years of boomers. The next generation, called Generation X, has nothing like boomer numbers for turning age 65. An alarming 51% of women in the peak boomer 65 zone have less than $100,000 in assets. I mean, that's scary. Among unmarried women in this demographic, the number jumps to 67% who have less than $100,000 in assets for retirement. I mean, I deal with a lot of these people, I mean, all the time. Who has less than $100,000 in assets for retirement? I mean, for some women today, far too many women, retirement appears to be nearly impossible. And the ones that I talk to, their biggest concern is running out of money. This might be a looming social disaster. This might trigger changes, good and bad, in retirement lifestyle choices. This might change how health care and medical care for those in retirement. And as I mentioned, more than 4.1 million Americans will turn 65 this year, marking the beginning of what the Alliance calls the peak 65 zone, a historic surge that will continue each year through 2027. This problem could impact 2 million unmarried peak boomer women, more or less. While my message today is about unmarried women nearing retirement, there are fewer but still too many peak boomer men in the same boat. Men generally have a little more money on average, and they do not live as long by a few years or more. Their situation is not as dangerous as it is for women. And I laugh sometimes because when I speak to the widows and the unmarried women, they all say the same thing. What's their biggest financial concern? I don't want to be sleeping under the bridge. They don't want to be homeless. They don't want to run out of money, have to sell their house, and not know where they're going to be living. The Alliance for Lifetime Income's 2024 Retirement Income Annual Study noted their ongoing conclusions about the challenging place where most unmarried peak boomer women find themselves today. The long-running effects of women earning less and saving less are now magnified and felt by millions of women entering retirement. Women also live a lot longer and receive less protected income from Social Security on average, making them especially vulnerable to outliving their savings. And this is another reason why when we talk with married couples, the rule of thumb is the higher earner should defer their Social Security payments as long as possible, hopefully till 70, because the husband usually dies first. The husband is usually, you know, I'm speaking in generalities, but the husband is usually the higher wage earner on average. So he's got the higher Social Security. So we want to defer his as long as possible, because if he dies first, the wife would then take over the husband's Social Security. So that's something you really got to plan for. And this year's study shows that women overwhelmingly say protection is very important to them when planning for retirement. Annuities offer a lifeline by guaranteeing income for life, empowering women to navigate retirement with confidence and dignity. Half of peak 65 women do not think their savings will last their lifetime. One in three peak 65 women are not confident their retirement income will cover even basic expenses. And the potential for annuities to address some or much of this predicament comes from two primary features. Principal is protected and guaranteed by the insurance company against loss. Number one, your money's safe. Then number two, lifetime income can be guaranteed regardless of how long the woman may live. The planning strategy is simple. First, protect what you have against loss. What you have is very dear, and some amount of loss could be catastrophic. Second, stretch what you have to maximize the income produced by that amount. An annuity can usually pay the most amount from a given amount of money. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. This morning, we're talking about the peak 65 boomer women. The statistics are kind of frightening. Over half of these women only have, you know, less than $100,000 saved for retirement. So we're going to address some of the ways that they can attack this problem. We'll have more after the break.
When interest rates go down, you may refinance your mortgage. When interest rates go up like they are now, what do you do with your retirement planning? Have you considered refinancing or reevaluating your current retirement plan? We are now seeing historically high interest rates that can impact your retirement accounts in different ways. Learn how you can take advantage of these attractive rates and how you can seek to avoid the volatility that rising rates create. To learn more, go to danwhiteandassociates.com or call 888-690-8820.
Welcome back to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. This morning we're talking about the challenges of peak 65 boomer women. You know, before the break, we noted the obvious that women usually get paid less than men, at least they were in the past. Women live longer than men. Women have lower Social Security than men. So they've got a lot of barriers, a lot of challenges to face when they approach retirement, especially if they're single. So we're going to continue along this track. Before we do, we have a couple announcements. We have a giveaway today. We have a brochure, the 2024 Secure Act brochure. So last week we had talked about the final regulations on inherited IRAs, which was part of the Secure Act 2.0. So if you'd like to get a copy of this reference piece, it would be invaluable to have with you. You can just pick it up anytime you'd like. You want to get a copy of the 2024 Secure Act brochure, just pick up the phone and give us a call. We're happy to send it out to you free of charge. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have three upcoming events this week. On Tuesday, August 20th at 5:30 p.m., we'll be at 9 Prime, new steakhouse out in Westchester, PA. Dan Simon will be presenting our very popular in-person dinner seminar, Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. And then also on Tuesday, I will be down in the Lewis, Delaware area at the Lewis Public Library doing a Council of Financial Educators workshop. Social Security, know your options. So if you're down in the Lewis area and you want to bone up on how and when to claim Social Security, that's a program you don't want to miss. The following evening, August 21st at 6 p.m., I'll be out at the Rachel Cole Library in Glen Mills doing a Council of Financial Educators workshop called Taxes in Retirement. In this workshop, we simplify the topic to help you understand how your assets are taxed, how the latest tax code changes could affect you, and what you can do today to minimize your tax liability going forward. So if you'd like to come out to any of our upcoming events, you want to pick up the phone and make a reservation as quickly as possible. So before the break, we talked about annuities as being a possible solution for peak 65 women who think their savings will run out. And again, it was a simple planning strategy. Protect what you have against loss. The annuity can do that. And second, stretch what you have to maximize the income produced by the amount of money you have. And an annuity can generally pay the most amount from a given amount of money. And people say, well, how can they do that? Well, the annuity guarantees a higher guaranteed income amount because it is pooling the similar annuity guarantees for thousands and thousands of similar annuity owners. Those that do not live long usually have the unpaid principal returned to a beneficiary. Those that live to age 100 receive their guaranteed income amount every month and year they are alive. It all balances out for the insurance company. This might seem unfair. It pays everyone as long as they live. What might be unfair is not living the life expectancy, not living as long as you hope or expect. We cannot know how long we are going to live. How can we decide with such big uncertainty? So the annuity transfers the longevity or the lifetime income problem to the insurance company issuing the annuity, and that for thousands of others. We call them mortality credits. I mean, that's basically what happens. If somebody dies, and I use the example, five women, all 90 years old, you know, they all put $100 in a jar, so they got $500, and they say next year, you know, we'll divvy up the money and we'll go on a trip, you know. Well, next year, unfortunately, one of the ladies died, right, and there's only four women and there's $500 in the jar. If they distributed that, they would all get $125 instead of $100. So they made 25% on their money. How'd they do that? It was sitting in a jar. Well, that's the mortality credits that I'm talking about. And that happens in the annuity world all the time. And this is the advice at the heart of the Alliance for Lifetime Income Research and Study. This is probably only a part of the solution in each given situation. If you are not too traumatized when thinking about your situation, assuming this is you, you might see some of the following actions that you can take to help yourself. Can you find a way to save more of your current income? That helps to some degree and shows that you can still help yourself. You might need to reduce your living expenses to do this, but can probably do something positive toward that cause. For example, find a way to pay off any credit card balance, even by taking out a loan. Credit cards are charging over 20% interest rates today. You know, so you want to get those paid off as quickly as possible. Thinking longer term, can you work longer, full-time or part-time? When you are working longer, even if it's part-time, you're not spending down the savings that you have, or if you're spending them down, you're not spending as much of them down. If working longer seems like a necessity, maybe planning for it makes it a more positive thing to do. I mean, I don't know. I kind of like work, and I know that sounds weird, but I like what I do, and some people enjoy what they do. I've heard people come into the office and say, well, I plan on working a long time. I like what I do. So if you can work longer, perhaps you can delay starting your Social Security retirement benefit to full retirement age or perhaps even age 70. By waiting to claim your Social Security benefit to age 67 instead of age 62, you increase your benefit by almost 50%. By waiting to claim to age 70, you increase your benefit another 25%. So, I mean, we're talking 75% more monthly income. We run these calculations for our clients every day. For single women with financial challenges at retirement, nothing delivers a greater financial reward than Social Security at age 70. That higher income amount is credited with the annual cost of living increase as well. Social Security is the best annuity in the world. If you win the lottery, you can take the annuity instead of the lump sum. Unfortunately, buying more than just a few lottery tickets will make your problem worse rather than better. Housing is, of course, a substantial expense in retirement. If you own a home, can you rent part of your space to a rent-paying tenant? We've had clients do that. That might be as good as part-time work. If you have much home equity, maybe you could look at a reverse mortgage. We deal with mortgage lenders that specialize in that area. You could sell your home or downsize, or you could rent. Would you rather plan on something like that or be forced into it suddenly? Maybe you live with family. Maybe you live with friends as roommates who pay rent and share expenses. Do you have any communal living possibility? The old TV show The Golden Girls was a situational comedy, but there might be many examples of that lifestyle for real in the future. 42% of peak 65 women are single, divorced, separated, or widowed. Then 67% of these ladies have less than $100,000 in household assets. The median Social Security benefit for retired peak boomer women is $21,400. As a result, women are at high risk of financial insecurity in retirement, said Gene Chatsky, a fellow with the Alliance Retirement Income Institute and CEO of Her Money. This latest, the Peak Boomers Impact Study, shows how much women value protected income, especially a paycheck for life, that tools like annuities can provide in retirement. Unfortunately, there is a huge knowledge gap preventing women from accessing these tools in enough time to make a difference. If you want to see more on this study or the Alliance, go to www.protectedincome.org. I mean, I really encourage people to go to that website and check out some of the facts in the study. It's kind of eye-opening. Guaranteed lifetime annuity income annuities provide another proven benefit. We talk about this in our office all the time. When you have lifetime income, you have a license to spend money. When you know what your income is and know it's going to come in every month for the rest of your life, you know how much you have to spend and you spend it. There's no reason to save any because it's going to keep coming in. Some of this brings the peace of mind so desired by all of us in retirement. Certainty of income can be a blessing. I mean, this is an important problem, and it's not going to be resolved anytime soon. There are so many people in this situation, and we all know a number of women who fall into this potential situation. Perhaps our family, our friends, our neighbors, our fellow employees, really every part of our community of relationships. And longer term, it would help if Social Security solvency were resolved. This risk is not off the table yet. It would help if U.S. healthcare costs, out-of-pocket costs specifically, were not so high and always increasing. Working longer, waiting to claim Social Security and income annuity solutions can only do so much. If we can help, give us a call. At the end of the day, it goes back to the kind of story you want to write. What will the financial chapters of your story sound like? Know that we are here for you when it comes to completing these chapters. You don't have to go at it alone. We would love to help. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820 in Pennsylvania. It's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. This morning, we've been talking about the retirement challenges of peak 65 boomer women. They do need some guidance. They're going to need some help. And if you fall into that category and we can help you, pick up the phone and give us a call. Have a great week.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of their respective parties and not those of this show's producers or this station. Join us again for more on